Welcome back. This session is a fundamental session where I'm going to clarify what is computer science engineering, and this is meant for the students who have completed their plus two or higher secondary education, who is about to step in into engineering. Many students want to get in into computer science engineering without understanding what is it. And there are a lot of plus two children who have completed requested me to tell them what exactly is computer science engineering, what will be the content of it, will it have only mathematics or will it be theoretical, is it all programming? There are multiple questions that are asked regarding computer science engineering, and it's the most preferred and people are behind it actually. So we need to understand what exactly is computer science engineering and what are all the courses that will be dealt with it and how it will be. First, let us understand the agenda. I'll tell you what is engineering, what is CSE, what are all the courses and what are all the broad things that we will study under computer science engineering and jobs and opportunities there, and finally where to start. And if you have any questions, I can answer that questions at the end of it. Now, what is engineering? Engineering is nothing but branch of science and technology which is concerned with the design, building and use of engines, machines and structures. This is traditional definition. This might look like only for mechanical engineering and automobile engineering, this is very preferable, but it's not that, it's even fit for computer science engineering. Why, sir? I'll tell you that we are going to do all these, may not be with the machines exactly, but we will do it with other things. So engineering is all about making things simple, designing, building, architecting and what more, that's it. And remember, CSE is integrating computer engineering and computer science together. Right, CSE is a department where a CSE is a study where they integrate the computer science and computer engineering together. What is computer science there? The computer science focuses on programming languages, mostly troubleshooting at the software level to be very fundamental, and they talk about the operating systems, how to maintain databases. All these things will be available in computer science. Remember, computer science and engineering, it is not computer science engineering. So they have got computer science and they have got computer engineering. They mix it together and that's called computer science and engineering. Now, computer engineering focuses on solving problems and designing hardware and software interfaces. It has got roots with hardware. It has got connections with hardware that will talk even about the fundamentals of electrical engineering and electronics engineering. So you will study the combination of the computer science and computer engineering together to get graduated as a computer science engineer. And remember that it is just not software and hardware. It has got electrical, electronics, and a little bit of physics, chemistry also is added with the computer science flavor. Right. What are the subjects that I will study, sir? I need to tell you that very clearly. The first one is very fundamental, and this is programming language. We'll have the programming language starting from C, C++, Java, DPC++. We have many programming languages that are evolving day in and day out in computer science. So when I did my engineering, it is all very simple. It was with COBOL, it was with Fortran, we were doing it. Now it is all about that. We've got Python, which is leading the role here. So you will study the programming languages. Second one, operating systems. The programming languages is very important. And another thing which is very important, equal to programming languages, is operating systems. You are listening to this lecture in a machine like PC or with your Android phone. Fundamentally, the operating system helps you in listening to it very clearly. For an instance, without OS, you cannot load your YouTube or you cannot see this lecture. So operating system is like brain. Operating system is going to be the fundamental, which is going to let you use the resources of the device. Be it a laptop, be it a desktop, be it a phone, your operating system permits you to use the available resources elegantly. And the study about that is called operating systems. You will learn about the Windows, Linux, Apple, and Android operating systems. And other operating systems are also available. Your university may cover it appropriately. Next, computer graphics. During the time we were studying, it was just computer graphics. There was no term for augmented reality or virtual reality. And now it has come to that extent where students are learning augmented reality and virtual reality through the tools like Unity, Vuforia, all these things. What is it, sir? Very simple. You are seeing movies, right? And you are using virtual reality headsets, right? The applications built for that headsets, the games that you are playing with virtual reality are all developed by augmented reality and virtual reality developers, and they all belong to computer science domain. What you need is a little bit of creativity, and you can use your creativity to build multiple games, and this is a very big field. I tell you, revenue is generated in millions and millions of dollars in the gaming field. And one good thing that computer science has been consistently building up right from the beginning is the area of networking. Multiple networking protocols are built, multiple networking standards are built. What do you mean by this, sir? Very simple. I have connected my laptop's hotspot to this, my phone's hotspot to this laptop, and that happens through a piece of code that runs in both the machines. And that is done by a computer science engineer. So you will have to develop protocols. You will have to develop standards for connecting multiple things together. And that's very important field. 4G, 5G, the evolution happens there. And you will study about computer networking as well. And data management and analysis. This is one field which is growing like anything. I'll tell you what, data is everything now. Data is modern day fuel. So you get a lot of data, we upload data, we download data, and all the corporates, all the companies, all the selling companies which want to sell something out to the customers analyze your data. What do you want is what they want to give. So they want to first understand what do you want. They do that through analyzing the data that you feed. The Facebook browsing, the Amazon browsing, all these are data that you give them. You are giving them a lot of data and they interpret it and analyze. One simple example that I can tell you is, if you want to search for example, HP laptop that you want to buy, you are searching it in Google and parallelly you have opened Facebook. After some time in Facebook, you will get the pop-ups and the ads about HP laptop. So how does Facebook get to know that you want a HP laptop? Data analytics. The data analytics done at the lowest level has now grown to very big data level. So they call it big data analytics, and it's actually very big data. We have got trillions and trillions of terabytes of data which is generated and which is managed, and that field is all about the data management and analysis. And the next thing is Internet of Things. This is the boom. Internet of Things, this entire decade can be called as Internet of Things decade, because there are a lot of developments that have happened with Internet of Things, and this has grown to cyber physical systems as well. What do you mean by Internet of Things? Very simple. I have a watch. The watch is connected to internet, and the watch gets me the data about how many kilometers did I run, how many calories did I burn. All these details are available in my mobile phone through the watch. How did it send? All through Internet of Things. The sensors acquire the data, that data is collected, it is pushed onto the cloud, it is getting processed, you get it as a clear display. I can monitor a motor, I can monitor anything that is available at a remote site, and I can see if they are working fine through this Internet of Things. It's all about the studies of how to interface sensors with the microprocessor, microcontrollers, and to collect data meaningfully and to do something out of it. Internet of Things is growing, and every day you get a lot of revolutionary products out here in Internet of Things. And next thing, cyber security. More the number of innovations, more the number of connectivity to internet, more the dependency on internet, more the frauds are, more the threats are. So there is a branch, there is a study that talks about what are all the threats that we have and how do we counter that threat. That's called cyber security. There is a huge wing, there is a lot of researchers, group of researchers who are working on that, and it's a very interesting area as well. Cyber security is so important for us. And microprocessor and microcontroller. I tell you, this is one of the best areas that anybody who is very curious to work with a little bit of hardware as well as software can pick up. This area talks about how do we program microprocessor, how do we program microcontroller, what kind of programming, assembly language programming at the deepest level is required, or high level language can be used for microprocessor, what kind of applications can we build with microprocessor. All this will be studied here, and this is one of the core subjects for computer science students. And embedded systems, the applications that you build with microcontrollers are called embedded systems. For example, your air conditioner, your washing machine, your watch, all these having microcontrollers inside are called embedded systems. And you will study about real-time embedded systems. What do you mean by real-time, sir? Very simple. You apply brake, the car has to stop immediately. That's called real-time. You land the, you are trying to land the flight, it has to land appropriately. Otherwise, it will be crashed. So that is real-time. If it has not happened at the appropriate time, that would lead to disastrous effects. So people are designing real-time embedded systems, and that's one of the very important areas in computer science. That is connected also to ECE, people say, but yeah, I connected to computer science again. Next one is infotainment. These days, we are having a lot of infotainment support in all our vehicles. Even the low-end cars has got a lot of real good features with regards to infotainment. It's one of the very important things. And data structures. This is very traditional, very old. The moment computer science started, the algorithms and data structures started. Researchers and people are working on developing new algorithms to solve problems. new data structures to solve problem. What is data structure, sir? Very simple. I have got 5 data entries. I connect them one after another. This is a data structure. I connect them in a queued fashion. That's a data structure. So whatever we are learning in terms of whatever we are seeing real time in a railway station in a queue, in an airport in a queue, in a stack, we are piling up books one over another, and that's a stack. All these real-time things are taken and they are realized as algorithms using data structures, and that's a very interesting field of study that you will understand. And then blockchain, this is most secure and this is growing. When your data goes into this chain, that data becomes non-tamperable. And there is a lot of research which is going on here, and it's going to rock us through with a lot of growth in near future. This subject you will study. And artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a collection of multiple subjects actually. So I'm going to tell them all right now. It will talk about machine learning. It will talk about deep learning. It will also teach you NLP, which is natural language processing. All these will be put in into one package, and you will learn how do you make a machine think like a man. When you are thinking something, you will take the decision instantaneously and you will be able to act on it. If you can get a machine think like what you are thinking, that's called artificial intelligence. And this study will get you all details about that. Health informatics. Now the medicine or the field of medicine is not just medicine alone and doctors alone. It's more of engineering also, which is added into it. If you ask doctors, they use a lot of software. They use a lot of support from robotics. A lot of software analysis is being done, and that is called health informatics. I go ahead, I analyze the data which is taken from the patients. I analyze and predict what can be the disease, and I support doctors. It is not the decision that I am taking, but I provide doctor with some information. I have robotic arms which can do the operations much closer than what a doctor can do. So all these come under one area of healthcare, and computer science play a major role in healthcare. Apps and multimedia. You must be seeing this video in YouTube as well. That's an app again in your mobile phone. So how many apps do you have? You've got apps for everything, right? Right from banking, Swiggy to order food, reservations, everything is an app right now. So that's a great field. If you can make good apps and if it is unique, you can become a millionaire. And e-commerce. We are buying everything online. A pandemic has made it a complete dependency over all these e-commerce sites. We are completely dependent on Amazon, Flipkart and whatnot. Everything is purchased online right now. And that's actually managed by a set of computer science engineers behind the screen to make sure that you are ordering the right things. It's getting delivered in the right way. The payment is all made right. All these are tracked through piece of software code that runs behind. And you will study about it as well. And e-learning. Your studies and your learning is uninterrupted, and that's through e-learning. For example, the Byju's, the Whitehead Junior, all these e-learning platforms are software. They have built a beautiful software platform and they are teaching you through that. So e-learning has got a huge amount of focus in near future. And if you are interested, you can become an e-learning software creator as well. And last but not the least, cloud computing. Yes, all the data that we are using these days can be ported onto cloud. It's nothing but someone else's machine which is sitting somewhere else. You, instead of storing your data in your machine and then bombarding it with so much of storage, you can store it elsewhere and keep quiet. You need not maintain that. You need not worry about the data. Everything is taken care of. There are multiple cloud computing services available, and all the great stalwarts of the software industry and the computing industry have already invested a lot on cloud computing. Microsoft has got Azure, Google has got Google Cloud, Amazon has got AWS, IBM Cloud is there, Intel has got DevCloud, and ThinkSpeak is from MathWorks. There are multiple cloud computing platforms available, and studies about how do we use the cloud, what kind of efficient usages are there, what kind of data can go in, how is the data secured, how do we access, all these kind of contents will come in into this. Now tell me, what kind of jobs will I get? Jobs are really plenty. The talented people are the need for the hour, and really companies are searching for those kind of people who have got skills in machine learning, AI, deep learning, cloud computing, IoT, cyber physical systems, data analytics, and actually there is a resource crunch. If you are really talented and if you can build systems, if you can understand things and if you can develop things, it's going to be great, and jobs are really plenty. So learn and keep learning. Computer science engineering is the only field which never stops you from learning, and it is called never ending learning. In fact, you need to learn every day. Sir, what do you have to have? What must you have towards becoming a computer science engineer? First one is interest. For any engineering, that's very important. Curiosity, mathematical thinking, and logical thinking. When I give you a problem, how will you solve? If you do not have it, learn that. Try it. It's all like artistic work. First time when you draw something, it might not be good. Second time you try, third time you try, fourth time you will be very successful, and the fifth time you will become an expert. So programming is all that. Mathematics is all that. Try, try, and try. Once you keep trying, I think mathematics will come in your way. Programming will come in your way, and that's no difficult. So we need to have no fear for the failure. And once we fail, we can recover and move fast. Don't think that programming is not my cup of coffee. Anybody can become a programmer. These days, it's very easy. And all the programming languages have become much more easier than what it were earlier. Now, let's come. Let's change the things in the world as it is right now to make it a better stuff. And that's possible through computer science engineering. I hope the session was useful. If you have any questions regarding any other stuff related to computer science engineering, you can ping me. I will be able to answer you. Thank you very much for following my channel and content. If you have any queries, you can reach me out and I'll be able to help you.